Welcome to My Opinion here on My Opinion TV. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, click the notification bell so as soon as a video is released, you'll be one of the first to be notified. And this morning, we want to talk about an incident that took place yesterday on Lincoln Avenue in St. Andrew, where a wanted man is among two men who were fatally shot in the Lincoln Road area of St. Andrew in two incidents yesterday. A third man was shot and injured and has been treated at hospital. In the first incident, it is reported that men traveling in a car drove onto Lincoln Avenue and shot two men. One died on the spot and the other was rushed to hospital. While at the scene, the police heard explosion nearby and responded. It is alleged they encountered a group of men who were attempting to avenge the earlier killing on Lincoln Avenue. A police source said the men fired at them instead, and they fired back, fatally wounding a man that they had identified as Giovanni Simmons, otherwise called Jeff. The cops reported that after the shooting, they retrieved two firearms, an M16 rifle and a 9mm pistol. They believe the firearms were being used by the gunmen who attempted the reprisal. One of the firearms was found on alleyway and the other on Lincoln Avenue. The police stated that Simmons was wanted for a recent murder that took place in the Lincoln Avenue area. Now, this is good policing. And of course, whenever there is good work from the Jamaica Constabulary Force, we applaud them. And they consistently have been doing a very good job as of late. However, you know, as it comes with the Jamaica Constabulary Force, whenever you have good work, then afterwards you have a rogue cops who go about doing something wrong and it puts a dampen on the Constabulary Force. But overall, they have been doing a very good job in executing their duties, finding criminals, taking down criminals in shootout and all of that. Now, this situation was a very good one in the sense that while attending to one crime scene and they heard gunshots in another area, they responded and they eventually took out a wanted man in the process. Recovering an M16 rifle is not a small feat. As much as it's one M16 rifle, an M16 rifle can do so much damage and can drive so much fear in the hearts of any community. All right. So recovering M16 was one, and also a 9mm pistol. So in reality, two guns off the street that could create real mayhem in communities like this. Now, we know there's a gang feud taking place on Lincoln Avenue. Several persons have been killed already. Lincoln Avenue near Arnett Gardens. Remember, a little boy was killed there recently. There's a gun battle between rival gangs, and it continues and continues. And when will this cease? Lincoln Road Avenue is more popular because of, you know, the dancer Bogland, Willie Agar. Those people made that area popular. Now, when these men, it is so nice and refreshing in a sense, when these men go on their attacks, that they are intercepted by police. And the minute they are intercepted by police, that's where the problem starts. Because there are no trained shooters, they fire widely. And then the police who are trained shooters, most times than not, come out victorious. I would like to see more of these incidents where these criminals, when they go on their operation, they are intercepted by police. And when they are intercepted by police, either they are caught or they are taken out. But, you know, it's sad for me to say this, but I prefer when they are taken out, because when they go to prison, it is not like they are reformed. It's not like they come back out reformed. But they go to prison, they make connections, and they make links all across Jamaica. And what we realize by these criminals is that they are mobile. Persons from St. Catherine are caught in St. Elizabeth committing murder, and persons in those areas are caught somewhere else committing murder. So they interchange, and when they go to prison, they make connections. And when they make connections, it creates a rootless society. We only see yesterday where the American embassy made a plea to its residents and its citizens to avoid certain areas in Jamaica. Well, what we can say this morning, a wanted man is no more on the road. Jeff is off the streets. He's no more in the land of the living. However, before Jeff lost his life, another man lost his at the hands of gunmen. Whether he's innocent or not, I'm not here to say that, I don't know. But at the end of the day, these gang feuds bubbling up in spurts of Jamaica, various areas in Jamaica, are creating problems for law-abiding citizens. Every single day you go on the street, you have to be very vigilant, very careful. You have to know the areas to tread, because at any minute, violence can trigger, and you don't want yourself to be caught in the midst of all of this. But we congratulate the Jamaica Constabulary Force. Good job from the Jamaica Constabulary Force, and we hope they are supported, and more people can give the police more information as we try to rid our good country, Jamaica, land we love, of these hoodlums, these criminals, these animals who are reaping havoc in our country. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Click the notification bell so as soon as a video is released, you'll be one of the first to be notified. Until next time, stay safe. Look out for a neighbor, look out for a loved one, look out for the children. And most of all, keep it locked on My Opinion TV.